everyone, and welcome to Elocin Legals in case you missed it. So we are now in June and I would like to go over May's posts. As usual, a bit of housekeeping. Elocin Legal has limited liability under a scheme approved by the professional standards legislation. And nothing is intended to give legal advice, and it doesn't matter for this video because we're just going over some of our services anyway. So in May we had four posts, primarily focusing on our services and what it is that we would want if we were the client, what it is we're giving to you as the client. So I've got four things to go over. The first one is fixed fee billing. So most of the time, most of our matters, we try to provide you with fixed fee billing. We don't want you to have any surprises, and we want you to know exactly what it is that you are looking at. If there's anything that comes up out of the ordinary, we'll let you know before incurring those costs. The only time it might not be fixed billing, if it's a matter completely on its own that is not something that we can't really determine what it is. So that's something, say, like a dispute or something. But we often do mostly transactional matters. So that's where our fixed fee billing ethos comes from. The second point that I wanted to raise was our after hours and out of office appointments. So we do acknowledge that sometimes people find it hard to make appointments during the day whilst they're working, or there might be other reasons. So after hours, we do have in the evening appointments if that's required. Weekends, we do ask if you can give us a bit of warning ahead of time to make those types of appointments, but we're more than happy to be flexible on that point. Our out of office appointments as well, if you are located locally or work locally, say within about a 15 minute drive of our office, we're more than happy to come and visit you as well. So that's our out of office appointments as well. I should also note our after hours will often be out of office appointments. The third point that I wanted to mention is what we focus with client service. So I've got a whole list of things that I want to go through, so I'm just going to be reading off something. Six different things. So we try to focus on open communication. So we want to be able to discuss with you what's going on with your matter. If you have queries, answer those queries. If we don't know what's going on, find out, let you know we're still waiting for answers, things like that. We do our best that we can. When there are times that there's a lot happening, we do try to keep on top of that, but we do believe in open communication. Intertwined with that is our quick response time. So even if we don't have an answer for you, we'll at least still acknowledge your question with a reply saying, yep, got your email, still trying to find out, or something like that. So we don't really like to leave our clients hanging what's going on. Another client service that we provide you is the portal that we use, the platform where we have all our client files. It's all electronic, but what this platform does, it gives you access to a portal, and in this portal you can see your status of the matter, so how things are going. There's a chat box in there, so you can chat with us, and that goes directly into your file. And there's also the documents that we upload for you. So you can see the documents that we have on file that you can access, and you can also upload those documents, upload some documents for us to see that we haven't yet seen. So this portal has encryption, and it's a lot safer than using email. The other thing is that we use electronic signing. Again, totally encrypted. And we try to not use paper as much as we can. Unfortunately, some things do require paper, but the electronic platform allows for electronic signing. And that's also another method that we can share bank details, because as you may or may not be aware, there's a lot of cyber fraud targeting solicitors' accounts, trying to take money from law firms or from the clients, and giving false information. So we try to use these platforms that have encryption within those platforms. There's another one is the verification of identity. So we like to verify our client's identity. We do that online as well. Again, it's encrypted. And the last thing is communication with you if we cannot see you face to face. So we can use platforms like Zoom, Skype, FaceTime. We've pretty much got access to a few different options. Our main preference is Zoom, but just another option, especially for some clients that are located far away. So that's something else that we can use. Our fourth post was going around senior discounts. So I've mentioned it a few times. We like to take care of our seniors and we appreciate the hard work that they've done during their working life. So we do like to reward them. So we offer senior discounts when it comes to preparing their estate documentation, and that's primarily around basic wills. So if a senior is doing a basic will with a power of attorney and guardianship, we offer 30% discount. If they're doing just a basic will alone, it's a 60% discount. And also if we have seniors who are selling their home and entering into a retirement village, will offer 10% off the professional fees for sale of property. So that's what we focused on in May, and I will see you next month in July going over Jude's posts. Bye.